You good? Are we expecting more?
First day that we met, it was, you know, there was just four kids here and just Ian and us, and it was kind of just humble beginnings.
Let's work together. Remember what I told you, we keep the line always.
But then as soon as, you know, the word spread and kids started hearing about it.
We do it on our toes, okay?
It was just amazing.
When we first began, families were hesitant because they thought there was a catch somewhere that maybe along the way, we are going to ask them to pay something and, you know, they can have their kids show up for no payments at all. So all they need is to just, you know, come on time and remember to put on their uniform and remember to learn and respect their teachers.
Just show up. We don't care if you don't have the right shoes. We don't care if you don't have, you know, the right equipment, even if they come in pants. Just as long as they want to play, just show up and play.
Then you pass it back home. To me, it's not even just about a soccer when you receive, but soccer is a tool. Just imagine those children who come from this city. They have a lot of voices they listen to every day.
Jesus said to the people, he says, the first rule is love the Lord your God.
But just for one evening, for them to come and listen to someone like Captain Jesus share such a message.
You can't touch the ball with what?
To me, that is priceless. That little word is like a seed. You never know when it's going to grow in that child.
And Lord, as we talked about the rules and how they're made to protect us and keep us safe.
It's such a powerful sport. It's capable of transforming lives. Who knows where it's going to go?